Here we go. Let's ride.
Hey girls, welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipes. Today we're going to make a dish that was made famous by some restaurants down in New Orleans, some very old restaurants. And it's basically a twist on chicken or shrimp. Made with wine, garlic, herbs, fresh herbs, and either butter, or bacon fat, or chicken fat, or a combination. And I've taken it and twisted it and made it my way, the way I want to do it. And some of them are called chicken a la grande or grand, and or chicken mosca or shrimp mosca, for instance. You can do it a bunch of different ways. Antoine's, down in the French Quarter area of New Orleans, established in 1840, does a version of this, but they name it something else, along with Two Jacks down in New Orleans in 56 I'm sorry, is when they were established. And there's some other old restaurants down there, Café du Monde, and they primarily beignets, which are Cajun biscuits, Cajun donuts, and Café au lait. And in Commander's Palace, 1893. And in some other restaurants in the 1900s. But these are some of the oldest restaurants in New Orleans, those first four. So I've taken my own twist on it, and I like it with mushrooms in it. You can omit the mushrooms or not. And I'm going to use chicken, so I'm going to use chicken fat to fry the Trinity in, along with the garlic and the mushrooms and the parsley, the flat leaf Italian parsley. And this is one recipe that does not use a root. So the gravy is just going to be a butter or fat, and you got to have some butter in there too, you know that. And wine reduction, and you can serve it by itself or on pasta. And I wanted something with pasta without a red sauce. That's just what I feel like eating. And there's some other versions or twists on it where they'll put potatoes in it, and I forget what that's called. I'll text over the thin sliced potatoes in it, you know, fried down in the fat. It's very good. All of them are very good. Garlic, wine, butter, chicken, shrimp, whatever, herbs, Trinity. Yum. Jump in your mouth. Jump in my mouth. And your tongue will come out and just beat the hell out you. And I've uploaded it a couple of times under Chicken Mosca, Chicken a la Grande, sometime back. You can go and search for those other versions if you'd like on my channel. I've already showed y'all how to search a channel, okay? Let's get started. First thing we're gonna do, you can either fry the chicken in a pan, not fried chicken, but saute the chicken down and brown it in a pan. But I'm gonna go ahead and roast it over here in the oven on a roasting rack. Actually, this is a cake cooling rack, and this cooling rack is going to keep it off the bottom of the pan, so it will brown all all the way around, in other words. And it's going to make a delicious bacon, chicken skin bacon, because I got skin on chicken. I'm going to use some thighs and some legs. You could do it with breast, but I ain't got them. I'm a man. Joke. And season them heavily with salt and pepper. We don't put nothing else on them yet. They fit to have plenty of other stuff on them. So you don't want to use a seasonal on this at all. You're going to be creating your own real seasonal. Funny. Look, the package says chicken rum sticks. I wonder what a chicken rum stick would taste like. The D got cut off in the printing. All right, go ahead and wrench these. I ain't gonna make all this. I'm gonna make about half and half. So we got them all wrenched. Let me give you a tip too. When you're wrenching it, don't turn your faucet on high, get after it. It's gonna splatter chicken grease everywhere. And you contaminate your whole sink. Anytime you're fooling with chicken, you should go ahead and spray some bleach around here. Raw chicken pieces, parts. So let's go ahead and apply seasoning. This is just salt and pepper. We're gonna bake these skin side up. With the smaller pieces towards the inside, as shown, like that. I gotta get salt on that other side. I didn't put pepper just to show y'all. Let me salt and pepper both sides, and we're gonna arrange it like this to where with the bigger parts towards the outside of your pan, it'll help them cook more evenly. Now we're gonna go ahead and bake these off at 350 degrees in just a regular oven until that skin makes crispy, crispy bacon. We'll pull off what we can and just eat the rest. Yum. After about an hour or so, you wanna go ahead and drain that chicken grease out of that pan and get your butter started. I used more butter last time. Miss JB made a comment that it tasted better with more butter. Anyway, yeah, that's some water I just poured in there. Gonna scrape some of that out, so loosen it up some and put it back in the oven and let it release. I left it in the oven a little too long, and I already removed the skin bacon off that chicken, and that is sitting right by that knife tip on the left. So there's that Trinity I done poured in there. It was a good heaping cup, I guess. And there's a whole head of garlic. Now I'm going to chop it up a little bit. See, it's chopped now. It was done off camera. And there's some mushrooms. Should have chopped that one a little better, but oh well. Some fresh Italian parsley, some rosemary, some oregano. Chop it up and put it in there. And I am going to add a little bit more butter after I taste it in just a bit. And that's going to probably be done off camera too. I use enough salt and pepper on the chicken. There's that pan out the oven. There's some dry white wine. That was Cabernet Sauvignon. And go ahead and scrape it down. And I left it a tad too long, but that'd be all right. And I'm going to play with that pan and get everything off of it, trust me. But I'm going to dump in what I got right now. Carefully, JB. I'm going to spill it all over the stove. You know that chicken bacon that's still sitting there on that newspaper fitting to get it. I already ate one. See, one's gone now. I didn't pull the skin off the legs. I just left it on there. Yum. See, yum.
Oh, it's crispy. And yeah, I'm watching a movie, so I can't turn the sound on. Oh, hell yeah, boy. And no other seasoning went in there. That was salted butter that I used. And the stuff that was on the chickens, both sides, that is all cooked down over the pasta. Oh, yum. Just don't eat this. There's some garlic bread I make. Just don't eat this every day. We just call this chicken a la JB. Yum. And I made some of those steamers, green giants, a ho, ho, ho. And I made these. These are delicious. Get you a big old glass of milk. And I showed it on my channel before. The recipe's been shown. Yeah, boy. Yeah, girl. See y'all in the funny papers.